Tomb Sweeping Day. It's one of China's traditional festivals, which falls usually around the first week of April. Following its literal meaning, people typically go to their deceased family member's cemetery plot and sweep dust off of the tombstone. However, these days, when the festival comes around, instead of discussing ways to honor a dearly departed loved one, the conversation usually drifts back to the topic of the country's sky-high funeral costs. With China's funeral industry becoming one of the top 10 most profiteering industries in the country since 2003, many Chinese people express their concerns about everything from affordable housing prices and just that they cannot even afford to die. On March 28th, the Ministry of Civil Affairs published a report on its official website, citing that the funeral industry has already become one of the most important issues relating to people's livelihood. Last year, the country's top economic planner of the National Development and Reform Commission, or NDRC, announced in March that the country's basic funeral charges would be decided and controlled by the government. Local government would provide an average of $190 in subsidy to cover the basic charges of the funeral. In some developed areas, this subsidy would be much higher. For instance, in Beijing, where the subsidy could even reach up to $800. In other cities, such as Shenzhen and Hangzhou, the government regulated the basic funeral costs are free of charge for local residents. But the report also indicated that, based on wide research that covered 626 funeral parlors, which account for a total number of 44% of the funeral parlors that are located in the 12 countries' provinces, shows that these funeral parlors' average profit margin is just 8.6%. In addition, over 66% of these funeral parlors have no government subsidies, which cause most funeral parlors to endure meager profits or even in some cases lose money. A government official from the Ministry of Civil Affairs said the funeral industry's exorbitant profit doesn't widely exist, and only a small portion of funeral parlors rake in huge profits via selling some alternative funeral services and even offer some basic ones, such as buying luxury scenery caskets, buying a shroud, not to mention paying for the funeral ceremony itself. The official also claims that this phenomenon is mainly due to people's desire to show off one last time, creating a sort of funeral cultural etiquette, if you will. Stick around, because up next we'll see where some of these exorbitant funeral costs are hidden. Don't go anywhere.